are oppressed by the devil. You are oppressed by the devil. The oppression of the devil can be healed in your life today. God can heal you from this immorality. God can heal you from this evil. God can heal you from what you're doing right now. You can receive healing. God is ready to heal you. His mercy is available. His love is available. But the thing is, it does not force it on you. It doesn't force it on you. You have to decide. The way you have decided to choose your way, the way you've chosen your way, you have to also choose God before God can accept you. You remember the thief on the cross? The two thieves on the cross. One was prideful. Those thieves were condemned to death. One was prideful. The other humbled himself. He received the grace of God and God forgave him. They did the same thing. One was condemned forever. One was forgiven. You can also be forgiven today. You can cry out today. Accept your guilt. Accept that you're guilty of breaking the standard of God. Accept that there's nothing good in you. The Bible says whoever says he has no sins is a liar. There's no truth in him. If you say you have no sin, then you are a liar. There's no truth in you. So if you have sins, shouldn't sin be punished? Should God just leave you with your sins? God does not do that. He loves righteousness. That's why he's calling you that, you know what?
This bicycle cannot determine its purpose. It is the manufacturer that can determine its purpose. How can you not determine your purpose? What made you? God is the one that can determine the purpose of your life. You cannot determine the purpose of your life. You cannot. It made you. God made you so is your method, your manufacturer. So it's the one that can determine the purpose of your life. Of course, I have everything. The word of God says, the Bible says, it is appointed for man only to die once. After which, you will have the first judgment. The thing is, what I can ask you to do? You hear? You're homosexual, you know what? We don't have anything against you. We love you so much. As a matter of fact, the only reason why we're here is because we love you. We love you so much, so we don't support what you're doing, but we love your person. We love you so much, there's nothing that will never hate you, because God does not hate you. Jesus Christ does not hate you, but does he love your sin? No. He does not love your sin. It's willing that you should repent. He doesn't want to love you to be happy. If you happen to have a friend, the union of this, that's high object, no you. If you happen to have a friend with you that there's a fire out there, what are you going to do? You say you're going to be angry at me. You tell me that there is going to be a judgment of God. Don't be. God is going to judge everybody. God is going to judge everybody.
God has not need your credit card. God knows you can't have a God does not hate that way. If God loves you, then I love you. What makes you different from me? I'm not saying he hates everybody. God does not hate anybody. God, if God loves you, then he loves me. If God loves you, then he loves everybody.
God did all people, then why did he make me gay?
God did not make you gay. It's your choice to be gay. It's your choice, it's your behavior. It's your God did not make you to be gay. I do not hate you. God does not hate you. You are the one that hate you. You hate me so much that you say different kind of words to me. You know what? I still love you. Maybe I'm not even hating you, but I'm not going to hate you. Why? Because God does not hate you. God does not hate you. Jesus Christ does not hate you too. Therefore, I do not hate you. Why would I hate you? If I hate you, I will not be here. I'm just running you from the wrath of God. I'm running you from the judgment of God. It doesn't make sense to you when you know God is joy. Does it make sense to you? Okay, if it doesn't make sense to you, maybe one day, if somebody murder your sister, then you shouldn't be punished. If somebody murders your girl, or your brother, or your girl, then the person should not be punished. If somebody rapes you, then you shouldn't be punished. That's what you're saying. God is too just because no overlooked sin. God has overlooked sin. That is why he came to forgive sin.
That's very oppressive language coming from men. Very violent in your presence. You're right.
What did you say? I don't know what somebody said. Anyway, God still loves you.
Yeah, wow. Good for you, Apple.
God loves you. He's saying you should have watched him looking for me. Do you help me?
Nice job!
Do you help me?
Nice job!
Do you help me?
Nice job!
Of course you help me. But you know what? That's why what you said to me. I do not hate you. I still love you. If I did not love you, I wouldn't be here. To warn you, I would not be here to warn you from what is true to cross.
That's why I love you. That's why you say what I'm saying right now.
Why does it not make sense to you that God should punish sinners? Why? Is it meaningless to you? Why shouldn't God punish sinners? Why do you think God should not punish rapists? Why do you think God should not punish murderers? I don't need to talk to you. You want to talk to the doctor?
Get the message.
Tell me what.
Your body is a dwelling place of God. It's called the temple of God. The same body you are defiling every day. You defile the temple of God. One of the proofs of the love of God for us is that it decides to dwell on our body. God is dwelling in your body, but the same body that is defiling the temple of God. I ask you this question. If you were to get home today and find your room being destroyed, if you were to get home today and find your room being occupied and destroyed, what will you do? So, what are you going to do if you were to get home today and your room is being destroyed? What will you do? Are you not going to be mad or call cops? So what should God do for you? You are destroying the house of God. You are destroying the room of God. You are destroying the temple of God. The same thing you are doing to God, God is not willing to do to you. It is not willing that you should pay. It's not willing that you should die and go to hell, but it's willing that you should repent and save. You can repent today, dear friend. The Bible says it is appointed for man to die once. After which you will have to face judgment. But does God really want to judge you? What does it cost to God to judge you? What does it cost to God anything? But the thing is, if God should meet everybody that is sinning, everybody that is breaking his moral law, do you know what is God is kingdom? With Monaco. How is God beautiful? I love Canada. Canada is that is beautiful and good country. I love this country. I've never gone home since I've been here. 5 years ago. I love Canada. But here's the point. If the government of this city decides not to punish lawbreakers, if the government of this city decides not to punish rapists, if the government of this city decides not to punish murderer, pedophile, those that are breaking the law, what would this city come to? This city will be chaotic. It will come to a jungle. So will God punish those that are sinning against him. You know what? Jesus Christ is a friend of sinners. He can basically to save sinners. He can basically to save you. You are not condemned to the bond God. Just come under him. You can take the decision for God today. The Bible says now is the day of salvation. Now. There is no tomorrow. Now. Why? Because tomorrow is not promised. You see, God is giving you 24 hours every day to make it right with us. 24 hours. This same 24 hours is only to repent on the against God. You spend 24 hours every day to rebel against God. Prepare God. You use F word for God. You don't want to see God. It doesn't matter to you if there's God. Do you know that God is going to judge you one day? Why is God running with the people of God is to come? Because of his judgment. You know what? God still loves you. That's my word to you. But here's the point. If you were to face God tonight, will you obtain mercy before him? Will you be merciful unto you? Is it natural? Is what you're doing right now natural? It's against nature. You're against nature. It's not natural. You know what the Bible says? Do you believe in God? Do you ever believe in God at all? The Bible says God made man in his own image. After his likeness, male and female. God did not make male and male, not female and female. It's a redefinition of marriage. It's a redefinition of marriage. The government and law defines marriage. Why? Because the government did not make marriage. Who made marriage? God. God made marriage.